Hello, good afternoon friends. Let's start the new oxidizing agent, activated MnO2. This activated MnO2 oxidizes the allylic and benzylic alcohol. We have seen yesterday or in last video the oxidation of allylic and benzylic alcohol by the MnO2. And we also seen the mechanism of these reactions. So let's see some more examples of this oxidation by MnO2. Now this alcohol is similar to benzylic alcohol. This is the aromatic compound, hetero aromatic compound, thiol. Then this alcohol is oxidized to aldehyde by using MnO2. That is, there is formation of this aldehyde. Then next, another example, OHCH3MO2. Now this again oxidized to carbonyl compound, this formation of para-nitro-acetophenone, formation of para-nitro-acetophenone is formed. So MnO2 oxidizes the allylic and benzylic alcohol to corresponding aldehydes or ketones. Then let's see more example. OHOME. This oxygen is protected by tertiary butyl dimethyl CA group. Now here is primary alcohol and here is secondary alcohol. Now the oxidation by using MnO2, the MnO2 selectively oxidizes secondary alcohol in preference to primary alcohol. If there are both the types of alcohol, then the secondary alcohol get oxidized instead of primary alcohol. So there is formation of carbonyl compound. This oxygen remain as it is oxide, and this OH primary alcohol remain as it is OHOME. Now here the secondary alcohol get oxidized by using MnO2 and not the primary alcohol. Okay, another example, NH. Now this is CH2OH11. Now this is allylic alcohol. By using MnO2, this allylic alcohol get oxidized to carbonyl compound. And then there is 1,4-methyl addition. The lone pair attack on this O-, then O-, then also then protonation. There is formation of C cyclic compound. So this compound is formed by 1,4 Michael addition reaction. Okay. Then 1,2 diol get cleaved by MnO2 to form the diketone. Whether this zinc diol or anti diol is present, then both the diol undergo cleavage by MnO2 to form the corresponding carbonyl compounds. For example, OH CH3, okay, and here it's CH3. Now this is anti diol. When this anti diol treated with MnO2, it undergo cleavage. So there is a cleavage between this carbon-carbon bond, and formation of carbonyl compound take place. So that there is diketone, yeah, dion is formed. So this type of the dion is formed by the cleavage of diol. Okay. Next oxidizing agent, chromic chloride, eta direction. Chromic chloride, or it is also called as eta reaction. Now in this ETARD reactions, the oxidation of side alkyl group, that is methyl group, present on aromatic ring or present on heterocyclic aromatic ring get oxidized to aldehyde. For example, toluene get oxidized to benzaldehyde. Toluene get oxidized to benzaldehyde by chromic chloride. So let's see the mechanism of this oxidation. The mechanism occur by in reactions followed by sigmatropic rearrangement. 2-3 sigmatropic rearrangement take place in these reactions. So first is, there is formation of ETARD complex by in reaction. So let's see the mechanism of this reaction. CH2H plus Cr Cl Cl O O. Now in reactions, this lone pair, yeah, double bond attack on oxygen, then there is formation of double bond between this CH2 and aromatic carbon, attack on chromium. Okay, so such a type of in reactions take place. So benzene ring CH2 double bond with aromatic benzene carbon, then this double bond remain as it is. From this carbon attack on chromium, double bond O OH Cl Cl. Okay. Then from the this oxygen, so I write this here OH and this double bond O. So 2-3 sigmatropic rearrangement occur in this ETARD complex. is the etard complex, and this etard complex undergo now this is skin reaction. Now 2,3 sigma tropic rearrangement occur here. Now this oxygen, the bonding attack here, there is aromatization. CH2 OCr OH Cl Cl. Now the proton from this carbon is abstracted by Cl minus. Yeah, intramolecularly the Cl minus abstract, there is formation of C double bond O. C double bond O H plus Cr OH Cl. So this is the formation of benzaldehyde. By using chromyl chloride, the side methyl group of aromatic compound get oxidized to aldehyde, and this reaction is called etard reaction. Now let's see another example for the oxidation. Now paraxylene, if there are two methyl group present on benzene ring, then it is called xylene, paraxylene. So by using chromyl chloride, selectively one methyl group get oxidized. So only one methyl group get oxidized and another methyl group remain as it is. So selectivity of this in natural conditions, if we use drastic condition means using the large amount of chromyl chloride, temperatures and applying pressures, we can oxidize the second methyl group. But in normal conditions only one methyl group get oxidized and one methyl group remain as it is. So there is formation of paramethyl benzaldehyde take place from the paraxylene. Okay, then let's see the next example of oxidation of alkyne tertiary butene by chromyl chloride in presence of CH2Cl2 solvent and another second condition by using zinc in water. So reductive cleavage by using the zinc take place so that there is formation of aldehyde. So such a type of oxidation of double bond take place to form the aldehyde. Now see the mechanism how this get oxidized to alkene, get oxidized to aldehydes. So chromyl chloride, now addition of chromyl chloride across the carbon-carbon double bond to form the adduct. And such type of adduct is formed, and which on reductive workup with zinc and water, we call as a reductive workup, it forms aldehyde. So carbon-carbon double bond treated with chromium chloride and which on formation of adduct. This adduct on reductive workup with zinc and water, it gives corresponding aldehyde. So let's see another example of such a type of reactions. CO2 can be chromyl chloride and second ZnH2. So there is this C double bond O get oxidized to form the CO2MeCHOCHT. So this double bond gets oxidized to aldehyde. So this is the Itard reactions or the oxidation by using the chromium chloride. Let's see another oxidation reactions by using the TEMPO. Tetra methyl pyrimethyl oxide. TEMPO. This is the structure of TEMPO. The name of this compound is 226, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 2, 2, 6, 6, tetramethyl pyridine 1E oxide. Pyridinyl oxide. Yeah, oxadienyl. Now this TEMPO oxidizes the alcohol, primary alcohol to aldehyde. In absence of base, then there is no acid is formed, and if there is a base, then the acid formation takes place. For example, let's see with base and without base oxidation by using TEMPO. RCH2OH TEMPO NaOCl. This alcohol get oxidized to RC double bond OH aldehyde. Primary alcohol get oxidized to aldehyde. And if we use a base, then the primary alcohol sodium bicarbonate as a base, then this primary alcohol get oxidized to carboxylic acid. So in absence of base, there is no formation of acid. In presence of base, there is formation of acid from the primary alcohol. So the TEMPO oxidizes alcohol by using sodium hypochlorite to the aldehydes, and in presence of basic conditions, the aldehyde further get oxidized by sodium hypochlorite, and in presence of base, the aldehyde get further oxidized to carboxylic acid. So let's see the mechanism of both the oxidation. Now this TEMPO get oxidized we see the inner cyclic form, the mechanism of these reactions. To form the oxonium ion by oxidation, and this oxonium ion react with alcohol, the base, abstract the proton O minus, and this O minus attack on nitrogen, so there is NOCH2R O minus. Nitrogen carries positive charge. Now this O minus abstract the proton, the hydrogen from this CH2, then there is formation of double bond to form the aldehyde. So RC double bond O H aldehyde formation take place, and there is formation of NOH. The O minus attract the proton, then there is formation of double bond and the lone pair of nitrogen is retained. And now this again get oxidized to 10 2266 tetramethyl pyridine 1-ethyl oxy formation takes place by again further oxidation. Now let's see the formation of acid. Now this aldehyde form react with OCl minus, that OCl minus attack on carbonyl compound to form the O minus. So it form the RCO minus. OClH, and if there is a base, then this base abstract the proton, formation of C double bond O and Cl minus get eliminated to form the RCO O minus, and this acid on okay. We will stop here. The tempo oxidizes primary alcohol in preference to secondary alcohol, means in presence of secondary and primary alcohol, only the primary alcohol is oxidized by the tempo. The oxidation of primary and secondary alcohol in preference to secondary alcohol, the primary alcohol get oxidized by tempo. So tempo in VCM solvent, here is secondary alcohol, here is primary alcohol, so in presence of tempo only the primary alcohol get oxidized and not the secondary alcohol. So secondary alcohol remain as it is, primary alcohol get oxidized to aldehyde. Now alcohol, yeah, primary alcohol RCH2OH by using tempo sodium hypochlorite and NaOCl hypochlorite, sodium hypochlorite, the alcohol get oxidized to carboxylic acid. Means in presence of sodium chloride, the alcohol, primary alcohol get oxidized to carboxylic acids. Let's see the example of this CO H2 OH here is Br. Equivalence of tempo NaOCl and NaOCl2 in MECN solvent, it gives Br NH2 COOH. So there is oxidation of primary alcohol to carboxylic acid by using the sodium chloride. Okay, we will stop here. In next video, we see the next oxidizing agent, CAN.